apartment in my father's house. Today, lots of food on his table, and no one is in the way. There is singing and laughter as the hours go by, but a hush comes the singing as the father.
away from the table, look out through the window pane, just beyond.
Given unto us, Lord, we pray that you come in our midst and be with us as we worship you and praise you. Bless us throughout the Sabbath. I pray, trusting and believing in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We are going to start with hymn number 388, Don't Forget the Sabbath. 388.
It brings response from them.
Jesus is coming soon. Hymn number 493. Fill my cup, Lord. Like a woman at a well, I was seeking for things that could not satisfy. And then I heard my Savior speaking, draw from my well that never shall run dry. Fill my cup, Lord, I lift it up, Lord. Happy Sabbath. Happy day. Hymn number 432. Shall we gather at the river? Oh, Lord is good and all the time. Hymn number 216, When the World is Caught Up Yonder. 216. Don't sing hymn number 614. Sound the battle cry.
Right. good and all the time. We shall sing hymn number 526. 5 to 6.
The road is good. The road is good. Happy Sabbath. We welcome you all in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. All of us, we are going to rise and we begin to welcome our Sabbath with our hymn song, hymn 375. Stand up and we glorify our God. Choristers, welcome.
Thank you. I will request us to humble ourselves. We kneel down for a word of prayer. And I will request each one of us to have 2 minutes of silent prayer, and then I will conclude. Let's pray. Holy, holy, holy Almighty Father God in heaven. In history, there is no day that you was not in existence. That gives us many reasons to give you our honor, to praise you, to worship you. And that's why we've come closer to you at this very beginning of the Sabbath. Honor, glory, majesty be yours forever. Throughout the week, we've got many reasons to come before you to seek for forgiveness. We have passed through a lot. We have spoken a lot. We have thought many things. We have done a lot. And of course, as human beings, we have erred before you. How we pray, Father, that you forgive all our sins. Have our errors taken away. Have our sins washed and cleansed by the blood of Jesus Christ. That our worship in this Sabbath be meaningful into our lives and be accepted before thy throne, on that very glorious day when you come, you crown us with everlasting life. We would like to pray, Father, for the mission, Zanzibar mission, Aloha mission, and any other missions that is taking place in the world. We pray, Father, that you stretch your hand that moves the world to move the hearts of people to come closer to you. Provide all what is needed to make all those missions successful. And when many, many shall add themselves unto your family, we all together glorify your name. Would like, Father, to commit into your hands the new students that have joined us recently, the teachers, and any other that came. How we pray that you give them courage, strength, to stay here in peace, in harmony, in one accord, as we praise and glorify your name. We have families, Father. We pray that you take care of them. We have the churches we lead as church leaders. We pray, Father, that in our absence, you take care of them as you use other leaders on the ground. We pray for our university, Father. May you bless it in whatever it does. Bless the leadership of the university. Kindly continue consistently provide for them a sense of direction in whatever they do, so that our university can grow from glory to glory for the sake of your glory. We'd like to pray for the preacher tonight. You appointed him before any other thing was done. You knew that today he will preach to us. Therefore, fulfill the message that you have told him to tell us. Let the message be brought into our hearts. Let thy Holy Spirit break our hearts into pieces so that your word can have a clear and settled settlement within our minds, that at the end of the day, we shall all together become new created beings because of your word, because of the creative power that is within your word. We all join together, we glorify your name. Thank you, Father. We are joyful that you have heard our prayer. Kindly, where we might have erred in our prayers, let thy Holy Spirit intercede for us. And let us always praise you. Thank you. You are great. On and glory be unto you, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. God is good and all the time. Happy Sabbath. Happy day. The Lord is good and all the time. Yeah, allow me welcome you all in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. This day is the 12th day of the month of May 2023, and these are announcements. This week, it has been Bugema University National Student Association serving throughout the week with the theme, "Together We Can. Our strength lies in unity." Number two. Next week is going to be Adventure serving throughout the week, leading to the Global Adventurers Day that will be on Sabbath 20th May 2023. Next. We are going to have a baptism tomorrow immediately after worship. Whoever wishes to be baptized should register their names in the chaplain's office. Number four, let us continue supporting Alua and Zanzibar Mission outreach that are scheduled to be in June, that is next month. The registration fee is 150,000 only for both mission outreaches. For Alua Mission, channel your contributions via Equity Bank account number 10024219445, or you can contact Wycliffe Anyona via M-Pesa 0724104189, and Rita Nakitende M10 077 31 55 295. For Zanzibar Mission, please visit our Buma office and register your contributions there. Thank you. This is from the chaplain's desk. Happy Sabbath. As we enter into the early hours of the Sabbath, and of course, as we have already entered, let us be hoary just as he who called us is hoary. Let us dress decently, because we are coming to meet the King of the universe, not in sandals, t-shirts, that is for men, not in miniskirts, trousers, that is for women, but be decent. Carry your Bible and don't carry it for formality, but carry it to read it. May God bless you. Happy Sabbath.
Happy Sabbath, Church, and happy day. We want to thank God who enabled us to reach this Sabbath when we are still alive. May his name be glorified. I'm here for welcoming an introduction. First and foremost, I want to welcome members of staff and faculty, and I will request two people to represent staff and faculty. I will welcome Pastor Dr. Javan Harerimana to represent staff and faculty. If you are there, wave to the congregation. Amen. Then I also welcome Pastor Tom Choma, also to represent staff and faculty and chaplain's department. Thank you. In a special way, I want to welcome Bunsa students, all national students, because this has been our week. Therefore, if you know you are a Ugandan, whether a pastor, whether a teacher, whether a social worker, whether any cadre or any course that you are taking, please, if you are there, stand up for recognition. National students, what should we say? Amen. Amen. Now, national students, you are going to help me. And you join me, we welcome international students. Because Ugandans, we are good people. And we are hospitable. Therefore, when I mention students from a certain country, Ugandan students shout a big amen. Amen? I'll start with our great friends. Those are students from Kenya. Kenyan students, where are you? Wave to us. Thank you for being in a good number. May God bless you. Now from there, I will go to the second country. Actually, it's a country which has only brown people. That is Tanzania. Tanzanians, where are you? Wave to us. Amen, amen. Thank you very much. Thanks for loving Uganda, and thanks for loving Bogema. From there, I will go to Venewachu. Venewachu, twese turi abavandimwe kandi twese turi bamwe. So niba uturuka mu gihugu cy'u Burundi n'u Rwanda, turakwakiriye. Isabato nziza. So I'm welcoming fellow students from Rwanda and Burundi. Please, Rwandians and Burundians, wave to us. Amen? From there, I will welcome students from Congo. Do you have students from Congo? If you are there, wave to us. If you come from Congo, amen. Please, Ugandans, shout a big amen. Amen. From there, I want to welcome people from Angola. Yes, I know we have friends from Angola. Okay. Botswana, because of time, I want to welcome all other students. If you are there, I have not mentioned your country. Please, you are most welcome. I can't forget Ethiopia. For sure, it would be a disservice to my professor. People from Ethiopia, I know there's my friend and my professor, Pastor Dr. Gabriel Warancha, with your wife, Matsebo, because you said you shouldn't pronounce Teddy because Teddy is your name. Professor, you're most welcome. Thank you very much. God bless you. Dear members, allow me, before I finish welcoming, in a special way, I introduce Bunsa President. If Bunsa President is around, please, you can stand up and wave to us. Is she around? Hello? Okay. If she's not here, it's okay. Back to the serving team. To start with, I want to recognize the presence of PA operators and organists. Wave to us. Thank you very much for the great work you are doing. We have served with Nurses Choir. And today, by the way, it's International Day for Nurses. Is it so? So today, they have been celebrating their day as nurses. Therefore, we want to appreciate for the service you are rendering to the country. May God bless you abundantly as you serve the humanity. May you wave to the congregation. Thank you. Pulpit team, I introducing Sesbera Obed, theology student. I'm blessed to serve you this evening. From the distal part of my right side, we have Pastor Ndungutse Bernard. He is the chaplain of a mighty school in southwestern Uganda field. You can wave to the congregation. Coming to the proximal part of my side, we are blessed to serve with Pastor Imani Shimwe Jonah. He is the district leader, southwestern Uganda field. Amen. The one whom I have skipped is the one whom God has chosen to break the bread of life tonight. He is none other than our Bumba president. When his time comes, he will introduce more. Both of us who are here, we are married. Except maybe the preacher. So, young girls, please. Okay. Let's be humbled and open our Bibles. We go in the book of Nehemiah, chapter 4, verse 19. Nehemiah, chapter 4, verse 19. And the Bible says, "Then I said to the nobles, the rulers, and the rest of the people, the work is great and extensive, and we are separated far from one another on the wall. May you be blessed as we worship our God."
The Lord is good once again. Yes, as we await for our preacher, I call the nurses' choir to come and pave the way for the preacher. May God bless you as you give us the song.
Joy is the praise. yeju upendo wake ni wangu
upendo
wake ni wako natujali sote siku za shida yupo karibu na siku za tabu kwa raha yupo mwamini yeye mwabudu yeye pekee. Praise you kwake mwamini yeye aliye juu upendo wake ni wangu
upendo wake
ni wako
anatujali
sote siku za shida yupo karibu na siku za tabu kwa raha yupo mwamini yeye mwabudu yeye pekee. Praise him sadly alone. Praise him sadly.
Happy Sabbath. Happy Sabbath. I want to welcome you in the precious name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. We are so delighted to serve you as national students, only that the one who introduced said, all of us are married, except the what? Except the preacher. I want to bring good news that the preacher also come December will be married. But I also want to bring good news to young ladies that we have 900 pastors. Surely of all 900, you cannot go without one. So I want to pray for you that if you are very strategic, you can go with the pastor in Jesus' name. I want to welcome my professors who are within us, amidst us. I pray that may God bless you. My name, we are going to share something brief and simple. Usually Sabbath evening, Vespers, we should be enjoying talking about the week. So we are going to study a very simple topic, and under the theme, united we do what? Together we can, united we stand. So as national students, we thought we would actually talk about unity. Thank you, Nances, for that special item. God's love is for us. And now, the scripture reading was from Nehemiah, and it said that the work is great, but we are separated among ourselves. So Nehemiah's plea was that we could come together as a people such that we could complete the work. Under this title then is, why didn't you walk? It's a question. But before that, I usually teach a song. I'm not only going to teach national students, but we are going to learn the song together. It's a simple song, and if you know it, we will teach your neighbor, then we sing together. I told you I used to be a teacher, and so I give marks. But I also teach brilliant students, so I can also give Fs. So work upon yourself. Now, the song is a common one, which I told you last time. It says, there is a home in where? In Canaan. There is a home in Canaan. And then the spelling of the word home is H-O-M-E. In local languages, it does not change. It is H-O-M-A-E. Now look at your neighbor. If they confuse those words, you question their primary. Yeah? Because the word home is a simple word. Are we together? So it says, there is a home in Canaan. Then you say, home in Canaan. There is a home in Canaan. Home in Canaan. There is a H-O-M-E. Home in Canaan. There is a home in Canaan. That one you have known, no repeating. We are going to Luganda. Luganda says, Ewafe mukanan, ewafe kanani, ewafe mukanan, ewafe kanani, ewafe ha, o, ma, e, ewafe kanani, ewafe mukanani. Are we together? If we are together, may God bless you. If you're not together, may also God bless you. So we are going to sing now in Runyankore. Runyankore. Owitu muri kanan, owitu kanani, owitu muri kanan, owitu kanani, owitu ha, o, ma, e, owitu kanani, owitu muri kanani. You are doing well. Lastly, we are going to do luo. Langi, langi, yeah, it's not. So it's a pachotie ikanan, pacho kanani, pachotie ikanan, pacho kanani, pacho ha, o, ma, e, pacho kanani, pachotie ikanani. Now teaching is done. We are now going for the exam. Look at your neighbor. We are going for the exam. We are going to start with English. I pray that the pianist goes with us. There is a home in Canaan, home in Canaan. There is a home in Canaan. There is a home in Canaan. There is a home in Canaan. Luganda. Ewafe mu Canaan. Ewafe Canaan. Ewafe mu Canaan. Ewafe. Ewafe Canaan. Ewafe mu Canaan. Nyankore. Owitu muri Canaan. Owitu muri Canaan. Owitu. Okay, the best one. Pachotie ikanan. Pachotie ikanan. Pachoha. Oh. Pacho kanani. Pachotie ikanan. Perfect, perfect. May God bless you. Touch your neighbor and tell him or her congratulations. You've passed. Yeah, but there is one I have seen. He's my senior. Most likely he teaches me, but I won't mention the name. He was saying, there is a ho, oh, oh, oh. But may God bless you. We are learning. All right, I request that we come back and offer a word of prayer. Let's pray. Loving Father, we want to thank you for this time. We pray that you guide us through this study. In Jesus' name I've prayed. Amen. So the question we are asking is, why didn't you walk? And soon we'll find out why this person didn't walk. Now we'll start with a verse. This verse comes from the book of Luke chapter 14 verse 31. Luke chapter 14 verse 31. We've made a presentation so you could also be looking through. It says, this is Jesus Christ talking. And he says, oh, suppose a king is about to go to war against another king. Won't he first sit down and consider whether he is able with 10,000 men to oppose the one coming against him with 20,000? That's a question. If he is not able, he will send a delegation while the other is still along the way off and will ask for terms of peace. In the same way, those of you who do not give up everything you have, cannot be my disciples. Jesus Christ speaks about this when he's talking about counting the cost. Now he brings this scenario of a king who is going to fight another king. And he says it is wise that this king who is going to fight another king takes off time to compare himself with the one he's going to fight. Takes off time to strategize. You see, it is us who go for projects, but we don't strategize. Someone talked about marriage here, And we also talk about that. Especially in our Christian circles, there is a stage after school and everything. So the big people in your family, especially the aunties, begin asking a question, what next? Huh? What next? They usually ask, now you've gone to school, now you are educated, you have a job, my sister, my daughter, what next? Are you okay? Is there any problem with you? Such questions. But I want to tell you, with this analysis of Jesus Christ tells us that there must be a strategy. Pastor talked about people coming. The chaplain and the department was saying that if you come to chapel, make sure that you do not come in sandals. You do not come with the t-shirts. You do not come when you are shabby. That's in brief. When you are shabby. Surely, even if there is someone's daughter who is seeing you and you come in sandals for a date, that is not good strategy. And someone's daughter, when you are also dressing in a very inappropriate way, you know you are dressing, but everything is clear, and even the thing that this man is looking for, he will say, now I've already seen, what else do I want? Strategy. There must be strategy, even when we are going for examinations, to avoid last time disappointments. The problem we have issues in examinations is because we don't strategize before. We need to take time and plan our projects very well so that we can be successful. When it comes to delivering lectures also, we assume that our professors have also prepared before. No, some students can ask questions that surely the professor has not actually looked at, but if he has to say, I don't what? I don't know. Then he gives you an answer. Then you also say, but is that true, professor, or is just giving an answer? Sometimes the professor can also say, we shall come to that. Next question, we shall come to that. Then you realize the whole lecture is saying we shall come to that, meaning we have not yet come to that. There is need for preparation. That is the principle in this verse. Jesus Christ is telling us there is need to prepare for what we are planning for. I have, time and again, I have seen students, not that I am perfect, but I've seen students that go through things, and then I ask myself that if only they had prepared for this, if only they were ready for this. There are things that can catch us unaware for sure, but I pray, just like Jesus is telling us, we should strategize. We should know the cost of what we are going to do. And in that same line, Joshua also learned this trick from Jesus. In Joshua 7:3, after conquering Jericho, now they are going to the next level of conquering. Now, usually there is a level of laxity when we get mighty victories. And someone has said that usually a mighty fall comes after a mighty victory. The reason is, one is, after a mighty victory, we become self-confident. In Joshua chapter 7, verse 3 says, when they returned to Joshua, they said, these are spies that are coming back. Not all the army will have to go up against Ai. Send only 2,000 or 3,000 men to take it, and do not worry the whole army, for only a few people live there. They got the right strategy. So they come back to Joshua. According to our analysis of the army, you cannot send all people. We are going to waste resources. You know, if there is anything that has made the American government bankrupt, is they spend a lot in their army. So the army is not something that takes little money. It takes a lot. So these army people who are genius, who are commanders in this army for a long time, they tell Joshua, do not waste our army men. A few people can go according to our strategy. They can go and fight this scarcity and they finish it. So don't waste time. They had a strategy. It is very good to have a strategy. Even when you're going to preach to someone is Muslim, you cannot start by saying, you man, you're not going to Friday's hero. Do you know you're worshipping the beast? Eh? In fact, that man you're worshipping is the horn. Have you heard those things? Is a horn, you are worshipping the horn. There must be a strategy. Find out the best way, the appropriate way of approaching. That's why we have Adventist Muslim relations. For those that are going to Zanzibar. And for those that are going to Arua, you need also to know the best strategy. You may find a group of, a mixture of all people. Best strategy. And what was the result? Joshua listened to their advice, and he sent people. And sure, the result was in verse 4 and 5. It says, so about 3,000 went up, but they were routed by the men of Ai, who killed about 36 of them. Let me also inform the church that the people that were killed were not low in rank. These were men that had served the Israelite army for long. These were men of renown, and they had what it takes, but 36 of them were killed. They chased the Israelites from the city gate as far as the stone quarries and stuck them down on the slopes. And at this, the hearts of the people melted in fear and became like water. Don't joke with I, especially if you don't have a strategy. I may actually look very small to you, but without a strategy, 36 may die. And so the verse ends by saying that their hearts melted with fear and became like water. Brothers and sisters, allow me to tell you that fear is something that happens to us. And someone has said that fear is false evidence appearing real. False evidence appearing real. There are sometimes things that we fear, but in actual sense, if we come, there is nothing. You know, when we were still young, we used to bathe at night. They told us to bathe early, but because we are boys, last time I told you, boys can be boys. And if you have a boy, you should not be very fast to beat. At least I have experience. For me, if they wanted to beat me when I was a boy, I think I should have died. Because almost every day, I would get a beating. Boys are boys. So we would waste time and then bathe at night. But there are times where you would bathe in the darkness. Because you are bathing under plantations of bananas, you see as if someone is coming to get you. Then you run very fast, you tell them, there is a man who wants to grab me. So are you sure? Yes. There is a man who wants to. When I go inside, the man brings his hands. Say, are you sure? So you go, of course, with a father and with a torch, only to find there are just banana plantations that are just there. Fear. False evidence appearing real. And for most of us, the things that are hindering us to move on is fear. Sometimes we actually fear to do bigger projects because we think this will not take place. Sometimes, however, the evidence is overwhelming that we are made to fear. But there are those who will say no. There are those who will say we shall look unto God. The book of Hebrews 10:39 says, but we do not belong to those who shrink back and are destroyed, but to those who have faith and are saved. We are saying that as Christians, even when the fear is so much and sure the storm is overwhelming, we shall not be among those who draw back. We shall stand and look unto our God, because it's the God of our salvation. There are those of us that are thinking of doing different things, but because of comparing whatever things that are happening, we tend to shrink back. Paul says no. But also let me tell the church that sometimes the fear is real. Sometimes the fear is what? It's real. And looking at what is happening, for sure, the situation may portray that you are going to die. That is why David says in Psalms chapter 56 and verse 3, David says that whenever I am afraid, I will trust in you. Whenever I am afraid, I will trust in you. Brothers and sisters, there are moments where for sure, be it a pastor, be it a doctor, I have a medical background, but there are cases where the caretakers come with their person, and people have their things that they come with. When they send you to that hospital, you are going to die. And so the question is always, is he going to be well? That's the question. Now, you know, medical people, they are trained that you should not make people lose their hope. And so you stand boldly and say, yeah, according to our analysis, he will be okay. He will be okay. In actual sense, but in the heart, you're saying, God, if this person becomes okay, it will. Thank you. In your heart, you're saying, if this person gets healed, it will be a miracle. But when they ask you, you'll tell them, no. We have treated these people. In fact, it's going to be okay. And they have some weird moments when, after telling them like this, you go away, the person dies. And then you have to face them tomorrow and tell them, what did you see that the killed their patient. Sometimes the fear is real. And some of us are too afraid that we fail to face fear. Too afraid that we fail to face fear. Little children are very good and are honest. As mature people, because we do not want to face our fears, we try to get all different ways of running away from our fears. Some of us young people can resort to taking drugs. And for you, that is how you address, you get your fear. And so we choose to be ruined by drugs instead of facing our fears. There are those of us that are old, because of the work pressure, they succumb to depression. And so you come to your office and open, but when you look at the work that you have and the targets that you have, you cannot progress. Little children are honest. Now going back, Joshua, after fearing, he goes to God. You know the story. He goes to God. God tells him, go do a search in the camp, and after you've known the problem, Israel has sinned against me. Find out the problem. Sometimes, brothers and sisters, we do not need to pray to God. If you know that this and this is the wrong thing that I'm doing, there is no reason for you to go to God. Change what you're doing. If you know that the reason I'm not reaching here is because of ABCD, the Lord has shown it to you, don't waste time. Joshua was wasting time on his knees asking for God's intervention. He knew. Many of us know what is wrong with our lives. But we continue to live in such kinds of lives. Yet we also want God to be on our side. Brothers and sisters, God is not bought or sold. So he goes and conducts this survey in the camp. And then this man says, for sure, it is true. I have sinned against the Lord, the God of Israel. And this is what I have done. Don't forget, we are talking about the title. Why didn't you walk? So because of one person who did not do his honest part, while others were united to go against I, one person brought the defeat of Israel. After getting this big history of defeating the mighty people that were in Jericho, they get another weird history that they were defeated by the slightest city because of one person. And there are many of us, because you are the best in this choir. Seattle choir. Is it Seattle choir? Squires. And you know it. The Lord has given you this talent. Because of you, you decide not to show up. And the whole choir fails because of you. There are those of us who think maybe because of the gifts God has given us, we could be wiser than the rest. And so we do not bring our input in the projects. And because of you, the whole church is fading because of one person. There is a game that little children play. You get a stick. It's called relay. Relay, from relaying. You get a stick. You give it to your friend. Another person also gets a stick. You keep running until you do what? Until you win. Now, there are two groups. You have to run until all people in your group are done with running.
Now, there are those of us who, like in this game, when we are running, there's a game I saw. Now, we're supposed to run moving from this side to this side. Now, they gave my friend, they gave him the stick. Now, instead of my friend continuing this side, my friend now took the stick the other side. Now, we are making noise. Please come back. We are going this side. Because of one person, the whole group failed. Instead of running this side, he ran in the opposite direction. By the time he realized that I am going the wrong direction, the other group had won. Brothers and sisters, if you are saying united we stand, surely divided we fall. The church of God is fading because of one person like Achan, who has failed to be united with the whole church. And these examples are so many in the Bible where the church says we are doing this, but because of one person who says, no, I don't want to do like the church has said, the whole church fails. In fact, when you read the whole story, this is where you first look at the aspect of ambushing. In the army, there is what we call ambushing. Now, what happens, the army has a project, as you can see. The ambush is designed in a way. This is the way that God tells them to set up an ambush. And Joshua does what God says. An ambush is arranged at the rear of the city on the western side. Joshua is with a group of soldiers that approach the city with the front. So the men of Ai, thinking that these people are approaching us, they run very fast to take them back, as the first time they did. So the men of Ai thought that the people are coming back in the same spirit as they came in the first one, but they were renewed men. So now they come in the gates of the city. These ones fight back. They want to push them back. Now Joshua, what we call an ambush, he has put, they are called flanks. He has put some army the other side, another one this side. Are we together? So as these ones are pushing them going back, this is what this image is demonstrating. If they don't put the army, they put a natural barrier. It can be a mountain and a mountain. But the concept is the same, like in the next slide. So there is an enemy who comes, like in the next slide. An enemy who comes. Exactly. The enemy comes pushing Joshua and the army back. Now the enemy does not know that Joshua has put armies here and the armies here, and Joshua and the main army, they are going to stage in front of this. Now when the enemy comes in the middle, this is what we call ambush. That was the first kind of ambush. You see, men of these days, soldiers, they thought that ambushing is just a new trick. No, God knew about ambush before. It is God who first gives the message of ambushing. So our God is wise. No wonder in Jude 24, Jude says to the only wise God. He's the only wise God. Now, what was the cost of Achan's being uncooperative? Because of him. Now, the archaeologists have told us that the ancient city of Ai can be found in this place called Etel. This is the remaining. But because of that one mistake, 36 men died. Because of one mistake of a person. Because of one person who failed to stand with the church when they decided, 36 lost their lives. Now, we are talking about physical life. But there are 36 that can die. They are dying physically, but also spiritually they are dying because of one mistake of a person who may think they are actually wiser than the rest. In history, we've heard of great men, but one of the greatest men is called Adolf Hitler. Adolf Hitler was a man who ruled over Germany, who said, today I'm ruling Germany and tomorrow I rule the whole world. He was very ambitious. He came up with this notion called anti-Semitism. You know, we have different words, but there are some words that are customized. Anti-Semitism is special hatred for the Jews, and it is him who brought it. Special hatred for the Jews. So he came up with this notion. Adolf Hitler was a man who was fixated. There are people that God has blessed. Brothers and sisters, we should agree that the Lord has blessed us differently. We should agree that Professor Warancha, God has given him a special gift. Dr. Javan, God has given him a special gift. Joshua, I have a special gift. And all of you, God has given you special gifts. And the reason is that we can combine our gifts for the glory of God. Now, Adolf Hitler, looking at the Jewish people and the way they were prospering, said, no, these foreigners cannot prosper. You see, the Jews had a culture that even if they came to Uganda today, they would find a place and a specific area in Uganda and they would thrive. Before you know it, they will be in the government, they will be in the banking system, they will be in any kind of system, media. In fact, up to today, many of them are in those big, big places. Now, this annoyed this man, Adolf Hitler. Of course, he had other things. He wanted also to prove that the Germans were actually superior, not the Jews. So he gets this notion that actually, the Jews, he compared them to germs. And how do you get rid of a disease? You kill the what? You kill the germs. So he spread this same notion. He spread this same notion against the Jews. Now Hitler and the Nazis killed, history says they killed over 6 million Jews in what we call the Holocaust. This is what can be done if we do not appreciate each other. It can go to a level of costing a life, actually. 6 million Jews. However, amidst this struggle, there are people that the Lord inspired to be good people. There are people that saw Hitler's idea as being not right. And so, they organized themselves into groups. And these groups were supposed to save the Jews from Hitler's Holocaust. Not all people are going to fall for the wrong side. There are those that God is going to use in each generation to do his will. And this is where we come to the title, Why Didn't You Walk? This special group of people, it's a common story. If you read about the Holocaust, there's a common story. Organize themselves to save the Jews from this murder. And so, they were coming together. Now they reached a brother and they told him, we are organizing ourselves to save the Jews. And the brother says, I also want to participate in this project. He said, if that is right, we need you to do for us something. Now the Jews were supposed to hide in the houses. They were supposed to move out at a specific period of time, not any time, because the army could be patrolling. And so, he said, we need someone to act as a cloak, that when they see you moving, it will be a signal for you to tell them, now you can move from house to house. But if they don't see you moving, it will be a signal to tell them it is unsafe to move. They asked him, said, I am able to do it. Says, are you sure you'll be able to do it? Said, I am able to do it. Do you need any money? Said, no, because the cost also involved him walking with a loaf of bread. Now, the loaf of bread would mean they were supposed to be moving from house to house to have what they were supposed to eat. And so he was supposed to move from one street to another street to another. Now, when people would see him, they would move to houses to have what to eat, because these people were organizing even the food for the Jews. So the man said, I am able, I don't need money, it is a pleasure for me to participate in God's project. Said, okay. And so he did it. Day one, he moved from one street, he turned, moved another street, he turned, another street. Then at the end of the streets in this suburb, there was a dustbin where he was supposed to drop this bread. So the following day, he does the same. He finds that the bread is not there. So he's like, praise God, I am feeding the Jews. I am feeding the Jews. He does it the following day, another day, and another day, and another day. There is a time that he did it, but to his surprise, he found that the bread that he had put in the following day is still there. He was not happy, but he dropped it anyway. The third day he comes, he finds two loaves of bread inside. He drops the third one. The fourth day, now on the day 5, the man got annoyed. He said, these people are wasting my time and money. Because of that, I am not going to walk. I am tired. They are wasting my time. Now, the day that he failed to move, brothers and sisters, that same evening, the group that had recruited him knocked on his door in the evening. And the question they asked him is this: why didn't you walk? But as you know, the man said, you know, the first days I was putting the bread and it was being taken, so I thought the Jews are enjoying my bread, but when I went for the past 5 days, my bread is not being taken. I think I am wasting time. Maybe the Jews have been killed. When he was still ranting, they told him, man, because you've not moved, 10,000 Jews have been killed today. Who told you that you are feeding the Jews? It is us who are feeding the Jews. Your role was to be the cloak. Now, because of you, 10,000 have been killed. Why didn't you move? Brothers and sisters, in this army of Christ, the Lord has given us different projects. Moving is something simple. These are simple things that God has given us to do. Simple things, moving. And there are people that do something closer to that. And there are those that feed the Jews who do a bigger project. Now, when those that feed the Jews think that they are doing bigger projects, they are wrong. Because even this one who is moving may think, I'm doing something minor. In God's project, there is no something minor because the work is so great, but we are divided. After all, I'm just moving. I'm not doing anything special. Because of his failure to move, 10,000 died. 10,000 lost their lives. He failed to move. He thought what he was doing was actually so minor. It is just moving. He didn't see the significance of him. Now, let me also inform the church that there is also what we call unity in diversity. The Lord has put amidst us young people. The Lord has put amidst us old people. He has put those ones that are under possibility ministries. He has put women and men, all of us together, because he knows we are supposed to work together to achieve in this mission. He has put us with different potentials, with different economic levels, in different age brackets. Because he knows then we can better do his work. And hence the notion, united we stand and divided we fall. I want to ask a question. There are many of us today, just like this young man, who think they are doing something minor. And so sometimes they think, let me not move. But because of that minor thing that you neglect, maybe that's the reason why that person you're preaching to has not yet been baptized. There are those that think we do not differ so much in faith. What you maybe differ from us is the Saturday Sabbath. The rest, we are the same. No. There is nothing minor. So if there is something you are neglecting because you think it is something small, you are creating a bigger space on the wall. The work is surely great. Yet we are separated with these notions that, after all, I am just moving. Why don't you move? Allow me now at this time also remind you that tomorrow there is baptism. Tomorrow there is baptism. If there are those that are saying, let me also use this chance to get baptized tomorrow, also prepare, because at the end of this, we'll have a call. So Jesus Christ, in John 17, as he finished his ministry, he says, I pray that they will all, the word all is inclusive, all be one. Just as you and I are one, as you are in me, Father, and I am in you, and may they be in us so that the world will believe that you have sent me. Brothers and sisters, there is no minor person. There is no minor work. when it comes to unity, everyone counts. It could be as simple as walking you are supposed to walk. Because of the mistake of one, 36 lost their legs. Because of the mistake of one who failed to move, 10,000 were killed. Now I want to request. There is a man in the period of slavery in America. He's called Martin Luther King Jr. He said that we have flown the air like birds and swam the sea like fishes, but have yet to learn the simple act of walking the earth like brothers. There is something that we must learn. Now, if they are there, if you're there, and you're saying, in one moment or the other, I have failed to walk, and because of my failure to walk, there is a brother of mine who is perishing. Because of my failure to do my simple part that I consider simple, the work of the Lord is delaying. Because of my failure to do looking at my tribe, my nationality, there is someone who is not getting the salvation because of my differences that I'm creating. I request that we stand up, that the Lord may empower us from today onwards, that we will walk, whether the bread is eaten or not eaten, but will not create the distance in the work of the Lord. I request that we stand up. And if there is anyone whom thinks that they should also add to that commitment, even the commitment of baptism, I also request you to come in front such that you join those that are going to be baptized tomorrow. I request that you use this time as we pray that the Lord may touch you, that you can seal the commitment also with baptism. Remember, if you fail to walk, there is a Jew whose life is being destroyed. It may actually be physical life, but it is worse if it is spiritual life. If you're there and you want to commit for baptism, this is the time also. I request that you step forward, and then we see the chaplain. You add your name to those that are going to be baptized tomorrow. All right. Let's humble ourselves and we pray. Holy Father in heaven, you are holy. Yet you have called sinful beings like us to do your work. Now forgive us if in one way or the other we've created a space on the wall. Because the work is so great, but because we undermine the work that we do, others think they are doing greater work than others, we have brought anarchy in your work. We have retarded your work by our differences. Father, I pray that the question of why didn't you walk, that it is never asked to anyone of us in this hall. But Lord, that you will give us these words that welcome faithful servant. How I wish I pray for each and every one who is here, loving Father, that we may be committed to your work, irrespective of our differences, but for the sake of Christ and for the sake of mission, loving Father, that we will stand together as your children. Help us appreciate our differences so that we know that you are the God who created all of us. Loving Father, bless each and every one. Bless those that are going to be baptized tomorrow. May you continue to bless us according to your will. In Jesus' name, I have prayed and believed. Amen.
sent you.
There is peace and contentment in my Father's house today. Lots of food.
Praise God and praise Him. The song is called Never Grow Old. If you know it, you sing with me in a low tone. May God bless you. I have heard over land, on the faraway strand, 'tis the beautiful home of the soul. Built by Jesus on the high, while we never shall die. It is the land where we'll never grow old. Never grow old, never grow old in the land where we will never grow old. Never grow old, never grow old in the land where we will never when a work he is done, and the life crown is won, and the troubles and trials are over, and the troubles will end, and the voices will bring with our loved ones who've gone on before. Oh, never grow old, never grow old in the land where we will never grow old. Never grow old, never grow old in the land where we will never grow old. Never grow old, never grow old in the land where we will never grow old. Never grow old, never grow old in the land where we will never grow old.
There is peace and contentment in my Father's house today.